What's going on, guys? Walt here with Ray Navarrete, former professional baseball player turned fashion designer. Ray, how you doing?
Baseball? Less than a year ago, I was still playing professional baseball for the Long Island Ducks, which turned out to be my last year of my career. And since then, I've been focusing 100% of my time on, my new brand, our new brand called Digmi, which is a new lifestyle apparel brand that features specially designed t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, snapbacks. We're trying to build a national, international brand around a great name and a great logo with a really cool message. So that's what I'm doing now. I went from the diamond of baseball to designing and learning how to design apparel and high quality fashion products. So pretty cool, completely different journey, that's for sure.
How did Digmi start? Where did this all, begin? Was it just like an idea, or how did it happen?
It was a combination of a lot of things happening at once. That's why I really believe it was meant to be. This did start during my professional baseball career. The story itself is now 10 years old. Not the business, but the story itself is now 10 years old. And this brand and this story was born from a nickname that I was given when I was playing as a minor leaguer with the Pittsburgh Pirate organization. For some reason, my teammates started calling me Ray Digmi, which I later found out was because of, the way I wore my clothes and my style and my colorful sneakers. And, at first I thought those teammates were kind of making fun of me or, kind of playing me a little bit. And it turned out it wasn't. They were just kind of acknowledging, the kind of style that I brought to the table a little bit. And it turned out that a bunch of my teammates really liked that nickname. And then the fans followed suit. And I put two and two together and I said, there's got to be a reason why people are resonating with this nickname. For people that know me, like yourself, everyone knows that I'm a pretty big dreamer. And I said, I'd love to do something after baseball. And I decided I wanted to get into the fashion world and start my own label. And we named it after my nickname, Digmi.
You play with some guys who are now in the major leagues who rock Digmi in the major leagues. Who are some guys that rock Digmi in the major leagues right now?
It's really exciting right now because what started with just me, in the minor leagues by myself, has grown to a list of guys like you mentioned in the big leagues, some of which we're celebrating next week at the All-Star game, which is pretty cool for us. So we have guys like Jose Bautista, the Toronto Blue Jays, who was the leading vote getter of all the players of this year's All-Star game. We've had David Ortiz, the World Series champion Boston Red Sox slugger, Yadier Molina, of course a couple of local New York guys, and Dylan G, who's become a very good friend and supporter, Eric Young Jr., who was kind enough to wear one of our newest t-shirts, the Digmi Subway Tee, which was recently featured on MTV's Off the Bat, and a growing list of guys. So went from one minor league guy to a bunch of minor league guys to a whole bunch of major league stars, and we're hoping that as the weeks and months go on that we're going to keep adding to it.
You said Digmi, the whole idea started like 10 years ago. From now, you have your own store. Where do you see Digmi in 10 years from now?
That's really the question, right? I'd like it to be at the pace that this story has gone. It sounds crazy to think, but I literally started when I was in AA with no idea of what I was doing, without one shirt. All I knew is I had a really cool nickname. And in 10 years since then, we have incredible product, amazing designs, and we have this beautiful store. So if you ask me where do I see ourselves 10 years from now, I believe in my heart that we're actually going to be an iconic brand in lifestyle apparel. I believe that we have an incredible logo. We have an even better message, and I foresee our product in retailers across the country, and hopefully if we work hard, we'll have a bunch of these little Digmi stores in some big cities across the country as well.
Right now, who's Digmi's biggest target? What player or celebrity do you want to see rocking Digmi?
Our biggest target, if you were to read the business plan, it says that we're 15 to 35 year olds. Anyone in that age demographic that has a sense of confidence, some style, definitely has a big dream, that's our target. But in reality, if you ask me and I throw away the business plan, it's really for everybody, because the one thing that all people have in common, regardless of their age, their race, their gender, is we all have dreams. So whether it is to be a major league star like it was for me, whether it is to be a lawyer, a doctor, the president, an actor, everyone's got a dream. And that's what this brand is based off of. It's chasing your dreams. So the business plan, we've got to give age and demographics, but in reality, this brand has been made and designed for everybody who is willing and brave enough to embrace who they are and to chase their dreams. And what we're going to do is we're just going to create a cool team of great kids that are talented, we're going to make great product, and we're going to offer it to those people that are willing to go out there and be themselves.
Who in professional sports would you like to rock Digmi right now?
In professional sports? I'll tell you what a great week for that question, right? I'll tell you what, it sure would help us if the king LeBron James was rocking Digmi right about now, wouldn't it? You know, of course, so many great stars in professional sports. You know, we really try to not only just take guys that are willing to support us, but we also want them to kind of fit our mold and guys that are very positive, guys that are involved in the community, guys that are dream chasers themselves. Of course, you know, my favorite major league player right now is saying goodbye this year, the captain, Derek Jeter. It would mean a great deal if at some point this year, even years down the road, we were able to have him acknowledge who we are or we're one of our products, David right here in New York. Of course, LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, you know, for his passion and enthusiasm. There's just so many great athletes, you know, I'm sure I'm forgetting a ton. I'll tell you one group of athletes that has inspired me, and I was never a fan of this sport, recently, the U.S. Men's National Soccer Team. What they did for our country for those 2 weeks to just see everybody root for one team was so cool. And, you know, we put out an ad that said, you know, we tip our cap that team for kind of bringing our country together. So if we could get a Tim Howard or Clint Dempsey, I'll tell you what, if they see this, give us a call because those guys are definitely Digmi.
Who is this? Who is the guy in the tie?
I get that question all the time. Who is the guy in the tie? Some people think that it's me because I'm the guy who started it. I'm the guy who drew the logo. And sometimes I think that's probably a cool answer to say. You know, let me take credit for it. That's me. The answer is it's not me. The guy in the tie is everyone who's out there. The guy in the tie is the dream chaser. It's the kid who's got some confidence and some style. It is the person who is not scared to be who they are. And every time that we put out a product or design with him somewhere in there, it's basically us acknowledging that customer, that fan, and it's our way of tipping our cap to them for, like I said, for being who they are, not just buying a product to fit into the crowd or, you know, to follow the crowd, which a lot of us have been guilty of as we grow up. This brand is about acknowledging and embracing people that are just willing to wake up in the morning and say, you know what, this is who I am, this is my dream, I'm gonna chase it. And this is what we're working so hard for. So the guy in the tie is everyone out there that's willing to chase their dreams.
What is it like to have your own business? You played pro ball a long time, now you have your own business. What is that like? Is it similar to being a pro baseball player or different, or what is that like?
That's a great question. I'll tell you what, there's a lot of similarities. There are a lot of differences. I will tell you one of the similarities, one of the things that are the same. When you build something from the ground up, people tend to be very inspired and they get very excited and they want to be part of the project, which is an amazing feeling. And when you're doing well, that crowd of people gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and they're all on board. And when it looks like things are going great, bigger and bigger. But then when you hit bumps in the road, when things aren't going right, when a product may not sell, a meeting may not go well, or you know, it's just a bad week of business, that crowd, that circle of people gets smaller and smaller. And it's very similar to being a professional athlete. When you're batting .330 and you're an all-star caliber player, your teammates love you, your coaching staff loves you, your front office loves you, the fans can't cheer enough for you. And then when you fall off of that level, and now you're a .230 guy and you're not driving in runs and you're not playing good defense, all of a sudden you're not getting so many taps on behind, and the front office may not be supporting you as much, and you know, the media is definitely not writing good articles about you anymore. So there's a, you know, there's definitely similarities there. You know, the big difference about this is when you're a pro athlete, when you get to 30, 35 years old, right away, no matter your performance, someone's gonna say, he's almost done. He's too old for this sport, he's gonna be done soon. Whereas in business, God willing, if you really work hard and you just put your nose to the grindstone and you make a quality product or you treat your employees right, no one's ever gonna say, you know what, Digmi's done now, they're almost 38 years old, their t-shirts can't be great, their message can't be great. So business, you have a longer runway, which is really nice, and it's very comforting, because I know as a pro athlete, I dealt with running out of runway space. Mm-hmm. You know, every year I played, I got older, and I knew I was coming to the end. Here with Digmi, I believe that I am, as well as our team, I believe that we're just getting started, and age really isn't a factor, which is nice.
So growing up, what was your favorite fashion designer or clothing brand?
Without question, Ralph Lauren, you know, in my opinion, not that I'm right, but he is the Babe Ruth of American fashion and maybe fashion in general. And the reason why I say that is, what an incredible and iconic brand, right? He has resonated with all types of American customers and international customers. His logo, the Polo logo, is one of the most iconic fashion brands in the world. And it doesn't matter what style or what kind of genre of fashion you like, I think everyone feels comfortable in one of those Ralph Lauren Polo Polo PK shirts, right? And for me, he's just the greatest. I mean, I think he had a quote one time, he said, he designs dreams, something along those lines. And I know that resonates a lot with me, so. Jeez Louise, okay, cool, okay. That's it, that won't happen again. Okay, next question.
All right, who would you like to see rocking Digmi in the celebrity world?
Celebrity world, hands down, and just like the professional athlete question, there's so many people that we think definitely fit our story, our message, our logo. But if I had to pick one, without question, JT, Justin Timberlake, for a lot of reasons. One, I am a fan of his work. I believe he's extremely talented, not just on the music side, but you know, the acting side, the comedy side. He's just, he's one for a generation, and he's got that look. You know, he is definitely Digmi. Whether he knows about us or not, he's definitely Digmi. Very classy, very confident. The women love him. The guys want to be him, and I think he would be a perfect fit, a perfect face for our brand. And we're working really hard that maybe one day down the road, people like Justin at that level of their success and that type of celebrity will take notice, not only in our message, but in our product. And, you know, I hold that hope, hopefully, you know, in the next couple of years that, you know, maybe we'll be able to get a hold of him somehow and ask him what he thinks about us and, you know, maybe even get to a point where he could, support the guy in the tie. So if I had one guy, Justin Timberlake.
Some baseball questions.
Yeah.
Most exciting player for you to watch in the game right now?
Oh, wow.
Younger, older?
Without question.
Turn on the TV, you want to see this guy play.
I want to see Mike Trout play. I want to see Mike Trout play now because, and I hate to say this, I'm getting older, you know, so I look at things a little bit differently now, and I'm not a parent, I'm not a father, but I could imagine being a father and picking a few guys that you would enjoy to watch the game with your kids, but also know that when your kids are watching that player, he's playing the game right, he's just a good example. Mike Trout is, in my opinion, the best all-around player in Major League Baseball. He seems to be like a great kid. You can see how much passion, how much he loves to play the game. He plays it right, and I think there's plenty of time for us to watch him. You know, God willing, he stays healthy. He's super young, so I think he's got everything that we need. I think he's got everything that Major League Baseball needs with you know, certain stars getting older and maybe leaving the game soon. He's my guy. If I could put on a game, I want to see that kid play center field, and I want to see him hit.
Favorite stadium that you played in your professional career?
Favorite stadium that I played in? Well, I'll give you a major league one, even though I came up a little short of getting to the major leagues. When I was in Altoona, AA for the Pittsburgh Pirates, Erie, Pennsylvania, which is, or used to be, I think it still is AA for the Detroit Tigers. Erie and Altoona aren't too far apart, and they did this special series when the Pirates were out of town. Altoona played Erie at PNC. So I had an opportunity, although I came up a little short of getting to Pittsburgh when I was with the Pittsburgh Pirate organization, I had an opportunity to play there. And that stadium is absolutely gorgeous. So for me, that was an opportunity for me to put my cleats on a major league field, which was really cool. And in the minor leagues, I've been so fortunate. I was on the inaugural Corpus Christi Hooks team in the Texas League, which is a beautiful stadium. Altoona Curve with the roller coaster in right field, which is sick. And then, of course, here in the Atlantic League, my favorite opposing stadium was the York Revolution. I loved playing against that wall out there and left as a hitter. And I got to give my team, Long Island Ducks, some props. You know, home is home. Not too fancy, nothing too special. But what made it most special for me was it was home, and we were very fortunate enough to play in front of great crowds almost every night. So that's my list of a few of my favorite.
You're big into shoes. What's your favorite shoe?
Oh gosh, I'm slowly getting out of the game. Not out of the game, but I'm, like I said, I'm getting a little older. So I'm on a more little like casual kick lately with some bands and stuff. But I am a sneakerhead at heart, and I am convinced, I'll debate this with anybody, I'm convinced that the Jordan 4 in any colorway is the greatest sneaker ever created. I think a lot of people would agree with me that Jordans in general is either the most popular or most recognizable kick of all time. But to me, the Jordan 4 it's incredible. And last year when I was with the Ducks and the year before, you know, I waited online a couple days in some of those cities we played on to go to some of those sneaker releases for the Jordan 4s. I got some military blues, I got the red Toros, I got the Oreos. So the Jordan 4 for me, hands down, the greatest sneaker ever made.
Growing up, who was your favorite player and team?
This is where I get a beating from friends and teammates. Growing up, I cannot deny it, I was a huge New York Mets fan. And my idol was Daryl Strawberry. He was, to me, he was everything. He was the coolest and the most iconic player in the city at the time. And like every young kid, when your player is either traded or leaves, you're heartbroken. So he left, I was heartbroken, and I vowed to never ever go to a Mets game or wear a Mets t-shirt or hat ever again. I was angry, and I just became a baseball fan, and I actually held that promise until I signed with the Mets in 2006. But Daryl was my guy, the Mets were my guy, until, and this is where I get in trouble, I am now a Yankees fan, and people can say, how in the world can you do that? Well, Daryl had a lot to do with that. I was just this general baseball fan, and all of a sudden in 1996, some young shortstop comes up, and I remember getting ready to play one of my varsity baseball games, and my coach is like, the kid did it, opening day, he did it, he hit a home run on opening day. And they were talking about Derek Jeter, and I fell in love with this guy, Jeter. I'm like, this guy is amazing. And later on that season, guess who shows up in pinstripes? Daryl. And earlier that season, Doc Gooden was on the Yankees. So all of a sudden, I started watching Yankee games, and slowly but surely, because Daryl and Jeter were on the same team, I became this diehard Yankee fan. So I know it's wrong, but I went from the blue and orange to the pinstripes. I am still a very strong Yankee fan, especially watching my man Jeter leave this year. But I do have a soft spot a little bit for the guys over there in Queens because, one, I had an opportunity to be in that organization for a little while. And as you guys know, I have some pretty good friendships with some of the guys that are on the major league team now. So although I watch the Yankee game and I'm watching Jeter's last season almost every night, I do flip the channels a little bit to check up on the Mets and see how those guys are doing.
You do a lot of work still with kids, younger kids hitting and stuff. What's your advice to younger kids who want to be a professional baseball player, who want to play at a higher level of baseball?
Biggest advice, kind of like Digmi, be who you are. How many kids, and I'm sure you guys, and you know well, being a player yourself, how many young kids try to hit like Derek Jeter, or they try to hit like, you know, Albert Pujols, or they try to hit like Daryl Strawberry? It just doesn't work. You got to be who you are. You got to be patient. You're going to be young and skinny and not very strong for most of your childhood. And you got to hope that your coaches and your dads are going to teach you the right way. So my first bit of advice is enjoy the game, have fun, and be you. A lot of kids get into bad habits trying to swing like a guy they see on TV, and it actually hurts them because they're not big and strong enough to do it. Next you know, they have bad habits. Next you know, they're quitting at 13 and 14. So that's my biggest bit of advice is listen to your coaches, listen to your dad, they know what they're talking about, and train to who you are. You will grow up and get bigger and stronger down the road.
Go-to song on your iPod right now.
Oh my God, wow. Go-to song on my iPod right now. Great question, because I think I'm heading out to the Jay-Z Beyonce concert tonight, on the run tour at MetLife. First of all, any song from Jay-Z, but God, if I had to pick one Jay song, I'll tell you what, people aren't gonna agree with this. Last year's summer hit, Holy Grail. Not even about the beats, not even about the hook from Timberlake. You listen to those words, you listen to those lyrics, me, you, anybody, we can resonate with what that guy is saying. I love that song because basically he's saying, listen, love me when I'm going good, and then when I'm going bad, all of a sudden you turn your back and you got something to say. And I think all of us, no matter who, you know, who we are and our life story is, we can relate to that kind of to that kind of story. You know, I think we all experience a little bit of being really popular when things are going good, and then all of a sudden people have something to say when we struggle a little bit. So I like that song, and it reminds me of one of my teammates last year, Ralphie Enriquez. That was his song when he came up, and I always got pumped up in the dugout when he came up to hit. So holy grail, Jay-Z.
All right, that's all I have for you. Anything you want to say to the fans?
No, fans, first of all, listen, I'm done playing ball. Check out Digmi. We got great stuff. We got a great story. We got a great team of young kids. And we're only growing. So hop on board now because it's going to be an awesome ride the next few months, the next few years. So come on down here to the store or check us out on the website. Thanks so much for the support, man. Peace.